What's up, YouTube? So I'm here today to show you guys how to use the latest iOS 9.2 to iOS 9.33 jailbreak on any device that is a 64-bit. So that would be the iPhone 5S, 6, 6 Plus, 6S Plus, and above, as well as with the iPads, starting at the iPad Mini, iPad Airs, Air 2s, and iPad Pros. So if you have any one of these devices, you'll be able to do this jailbreak. Currently, there isn't an English version, but we can continue with the version available. Make sure you grab the latest build too that's available on the website here when you click. If you use Google Chrome, you can translate most of these web pages, so you're able to follow along on the tutorials here, or you can follow along on the tutorial in the video. Once you've downloaded and installed this, it's just a pretty simple click install and then it's complete. You'll have the app. Now, make sure, if you haven't done this yet, to trust the device that you've plugged into your computer here. Now, I've freshly restored this device. I've tried the jailbreak a few times, but let's do it again. Now, this window is going to pop up here, and this is actually the jailbreak window here. So, what you're going to want to do is click on this green button here, and you're going to want to shut off your device. Now, just be patient until you see the text change, just like it does here. It's very important that you shut the device off during this stage. Then enter in the correct CAPTCHA here. Click here. Now, at this portion, you're going to need to create an Apple ID, just a fake or a free Apple ID, or you can use your Apple ID that you have if you don't trust. I'm going to use one that I've already created for this. And it is, I just want to throw it out there, this is safe to do. It's been tested many a times, so this is just for the certificate. So once you've done that, this process will take another moment here. Leave your device off like you see in the screen. Now, I actually attempted this jailbreak 4 or 5 times before I did this video, so mine succeeds right away because I've gone through the steps a few times and kind of know which ways to do it. If this fails for you guys here, you can see that my jailbreak succeeded, at least to the device. Don't get discouraged. Close down the application, open it back up, and run the tool again, basically starting from the first steps here. So, once this is complete and you have this screen, you're finished on the computer side. We can switch just primarily over to the device side. Now, on the device, you'll want to wake it back up, and you'll notice you have a new app on your home screen here. So, before you open this app, you actually have to trust the certificate that was used to install this application. So, to do this, you have to go into settings. And then you want to go into general. And then from in general, you want to scroll down to device management. And you'll see developer app. You'll want to trust. You will need an active internet connection for this. Once it's been trusted, you can actually exit out of the settings application. Head back over to the new pangu app that's been installed. So this is the jailbreak app. Now, this is an on-demand jailbreak. So basically, We haven't jailbroken this device yet. All we've done is install an app to the phone, and this is the actual jailbreak itself. So it's not a tethered jailbreak or an untethered jailbreak, it's an on-demand jailbreak. So basically, every time your device reboots, it'll be in a non-jailbreak state. When you run this app, it'll respring into a jailbroken state. Every time you reboot your device, you'll just have to rerun this application to get it to jailbreak. So a lot of people have had a lot of issues getting to this point, getting Cydia to install. So I'm just going to show you guys how I've been able to do it no problem here. So what you actually want to do is close the app the first time you open it up, and then close everything else you have in your app switcher here, just like this, right? Open the application back up. Be prepared to push the button right here, so your power button. If your power button is to the top on like the iPhone SE or the 5S, make sure you're ready for that. So my power button's right here. You're gonna wanna tap this circle and hit the power button right away and just leave it. So you see right away, I get the storage is almost full notification, and then I get the Cydia is being installed or being initialized notification. Again, leave the device. And you see mine did it really quick right away. This process, because it's installing Cydia, will take a long time for the first time. After that, it'll go a lot quicker, like when you reboot the device. So we'll just wait for that to come back and do a respring. Alright, so once our device is respringed here, we can go back in and you'll be greeted with two new applications now. So you'll have three in total. You'll have the jailbreak application, which you'll always keep. That will initialize the jailbreak. We'll now have Cydia, which is this jailbreak store where you'll get all your tweaks. And then you'll see this other application here. This is like an app sync or an app cake pirate app store, and you can actually remove it with Cydia here. So we're going to jump into Cydia really quickly, allow it to do its first run, which will take a little bit of time. Once Cydia has fully reloaded, you can go under here to installed, and you'll be under the user tab. You'll see you only have a few packages installed, and it is safe to remove this PP package here, the PP 3.0. So you can safely remove this. So once you've removed that there, you'll want to reboot your device, just because it's good to do a reboot, I find, after any jailbreak to make sure everything is working properly. This will also give me a chance to show you guys how to get back into a jailbroken state. So essentially now, the jailbreak sticks to the device. If you install a bunch of tweaks, you're not going to lose the jailbreak or those tweaks. You're not going to have to reinstall them every time you reboot your phone. It's just when the phone reboots, it'll be like it's stock without a jailbreak. So there'll be no modifications running whatsoever. So the device boots up pretty quick, non-jailbroken. If we were to try to launch Cydia right now, it would just fail. And I will give you guys a quick demonstration of that. So we're back. The apps are here. But if we try to go into Cydia, you can see it just fails. So we're currently not jailbroken. So what do? Well, you don't have to reinstall everything, but clear all the apps in the app switcher like you've seen here. Open up the app, and then again, you'll want to do this where you're really quickly to the power button. So if you have, again, the iPhone 5S or the iPhone SE power button to the top. You'll want to do this very quickly, so tap and power off. If you can do this really quick, you'll have usually no problems getting back into a jailbroken state. So as you can see here, my jailbreak kicked in very quickly. It's very smooth, and we will be able to open up Cydia no problem. So effectively, it's not an untethered jailbreak, it's not a tethered jailbreak, it's an on-demand jailbreak. And I actually like it. It has a lot of useful new features with that, so that's pretty cool. This is how you guys do it. Let me know if you have any other questions. Leave a comment below. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again next time. Cheers.